Let's dive deeper into concerns around spreading misinformation, its consequences, and securing our votes. Some of the most pointed attacks during today's Senate hearing included examples of how the leading social media platforms have been used to spread misinformation. William Brangham explores how that misinformation can be transmitted easily by American voters and influence thinking. Afterwards, he has an interview with one of the top officials from the Department of Homeland Security.
Thank you so much.
Have you heard that voter fraud is rampant in the U.S.? Well, it isn't. Or that Bill Gates is going to microchip Americans using the COVID-19 vaccine? That's also false. Or that President Trump didn't really have the coronavirus? Wrong. He did. None of these are true, but they've been read and spread by millions. And they represent just drops in a vast ocean of misinformation.
Good morning, everybody. Have a busy day.
It's become such a pervasive problem that a small industry of fact-checkers, like the people here at PolitiFact, is working overtime to debunk them.
And Amy has a good fact-check on whether Biden is a socialist or supports socialist policies.
All the major social media platforms are trying to flag false or misleading claims posted on their sites. There are online courses teaching citizens how to distinguish truth from fiction.
And try to think what your inherent biases or lenses might be that are causing you to see news in a certain way.
We sat in on one for senior citizens run by a group called Senior Planet.
So it really impacts everybody when people disseminate fake news.
People who are susceptible to misinformation includes anyone who has a pre-existing opinion about anything. So anyone.
Danigal Young of the University of Delaware studies misinformation. She says the pandemic has only made it worse.
When you think about this in terms of evolutionary psychology, we are hardwired for survival, especially when we are under conditions that mimic fear and threat. So, you know, if you are encountering a tiger in the jungle or something, you're not going to do a slow pro-con list of the different courses of action that you might take. Instead, you're actually just going to make a decision quickly based on emotions and intuition, and the person who writes the pro-con list will be eaten by the tiger.
You suspect that there's some foul play going on there?
On the issue of the pandemic, retired veteran Kel Bales from Wisconsin has real questions about whether the official coronavirus death toll is accurate.
I feel strongly that there's a lot of political motivation behind a lot of these kind of numbers being pushed out there.
Bales is an ordained pastor and a supporter of President Trump. In his media ecosystem, which is largely conservative voices, anything but a Trump win would be evidence of foul play.
If Biden were to win the presidency, seems to be pretty clear evidence of fraud. We're all skewed, right? My particular Facebook feed is blown up with conservative, with like-minded individuals. We're all going to do that. We're going to surround ourselves with circles of like believers, like thinkers.
I don't listen to any regular TV news because it's not telling everything out there.
Arlene LeHue lives in the Villages in Florida. It's a large retirement community. She's a grandmother and enjoys riding motorcycles.
I go online to Newsmax, Parler. I follow Dan Bongino.
So those are all fairly what people would argue are conservative news sites or from a right perspective.
Yeah, I don't agree with that. I just feel it's truthful. I don't know if it's conservative or not. I think people that are on the Democratic side, and I used to be a Democrat, so people that are on the Democratic side don't really want to hear the truth sometimes.
Misinformation is nothing new, of course. Abe Lincoln back there, as with every other president, has been tarred with all sorts of lies and untruths. The difference is that back then, the misinformation could only travel as fast as the railroads could take it. Nowadays, all you need is a few seconds, and this, and it's everywhere. Kel Bales shares posts to his Facebook page, like this video of President Trump falsely alleging that there's widespread fraud with mail-in ballots.
This election will be the most rigged election in history.
When you look at all these organizations that say that there might be a incredibly rare instances of people casting votes illegally, but it's 0.00000% of votes cast. That doesn't give you any comfort?
Again, if we look at the numbers, if that's truly the number out there, I'll have to again do my own research. I mean, I'm sure there are independent organizations out there doing the research, and that's great. I applaud them for it. But ultimately, again, it's that my personal gut check.
They found a lot of ballots, like in the ocean and trunks and garbage cans. Dead people are getting ballots. Animals are getting ballots. My friend got one from a dog down the street. His dog's name's Charlie. He got a ballot.
Was mailed a ballot?
Yes. Well, his name's Charlie, the dog. So it's Charlie, whatever their last name is, and he got a ballot.
It may sound preposterous, and of course pets can't vote, but often misinformation starts with a kernel of truth. One voting group did mistakenly mail a registration form to a deceased cat in Atlanta. But Danigel Young says fact-checking alone isn't likely to address this ocean of misinformation.
If you can connect on the very needs and desires that are driving people to hold these beliefs in the first place, right, create those connections, that's where we create an inroad. It's hard because, you know, we're asking you to have empathy for individuals who might be holding beliefs that could undermine your own freedom or undermine certain aspects of social justice. But this, if the goal is to correct misperceptions, then those relationships have to come first.